Yes, this piece of ornament you see right here, I don't know what to call it, but all I know that this means a lot to me. A lot of people come in here and see it, see this Bob Marley with the labels and whatever, but the history I will never tell anyone about the whole information of the history. But when Bob Marley had the press down Marcus Garvey, there was order for around 1 million records there. I think it was Africa, going to some places. And when the guy was pressing it, man, he was there, and all these things are cuttings. And every record they play and cut, all the cuttings come off, not the dread. I take them up, pop them up into a box, and I take it. And these are one of this foil record. I think it's the second record that press off it, or the last one, something like that. So I just take it and I just make my art for as the observer with it, because Bob Marley was a man that I love that much. And then he always talk a lot, you know. And I get offer for this for 3,000. A guy come in here, a white guy come in here and say, hey, I give you 3,000 for that. But he don't know how much it value and what it value. So I said, no, I'm not selling it, you know what I mean? But what I do now, I get architect guy tell me that I know Jamaica is the wood. It's the wood and water, the land of wood and water. He say he want to take off, all these gonna take off, and he want to make it different, like glass it, glass around, but I don't know if the glass will make it look different and spoil it, you know, image of it. So I'm thinking about it before, you know, I do that. But this is a lovely piece of work, you know, and I'm not gonna sell a guy for 3,000 US or whatever, because I know years to come down, this is Bob Marley, right? Although it's not the signature of Bob Marley, there was no way to put the signature, but his record is there for the signature. I mean, and this is an original label of Natty Dread, so you know, this is it. You know, so, you know, I just put up this for, keep it for, you know, a piece of, you know, prize or whatever, but, you know. And when I'm ready to sell, I will tell you guys, you know, that, you know, even the guys I'm around me, just like Jimmy Cliff have his private guitar the other day, and he put it up for the foundation, and I don't know what I will do with this yet, but I would have to get a dream by Bob Marley to know what I'm doing, because I've been Johnny Marley while, you know, because we was friend. He liked to tease Niney, and he liked to punch me, and he liked, you know, a lot of things, you know what I mean, so, and that is why, the way how me and him moved so nice, this was it, way how I get tied with Ritter, could go to Africa, because me is the first one who introduced Ritter to Ghana, you know, and she know how it goes. So Bobby, my friend, and I want to keep that on. I don't know if I'm gonna get away with that. It have to be some personal things going towards, you know what I mean? I going in some great place, whether some palace, like man like Al Obama, who love Bob Marley, travel from New York, this big plane come down here, and the first songs that he played his Airway Force. I don't know which song, but I hear somebody say he was playing some songs. I don't know if he have this, but this man is the only man them I would really turn over all these things to and say, hey, this is, because I know they love Bob. I'm not gonna give somebody who don't even love Bob or recognize Bob. You know what I mean? So this is where it stand right now. You know what I mean? Not a dread.